So my name is Christoph. I'm the founder and CEO of Sercat, AI for livestock herd management. Every year, 700,000 people die because of the overuse of the antibiotics. In other words, antibiotic resistance. Where is this resistance coming from? 2/3 of the antibiotic used in the livestock industry, 75% for non-therapeutic reasons, means growth promotion. Is it only affecting the meat? No. It's also affecting the fruits, vegetables, and also the drinking lines through the water of the farms. So we went there 2 years ago with my co-founder Attila, and we spoke with the farmers, and we are doing this continuously. It turned out they are also not happy about the situation. With the example, John is the farmer. He has 1,000 pigs. He has a 16% mortality rate, which is causing him 22,000 euro losses in every year. Plus, if he has a sick animal in the pen, then he had to inject the whole group because there is no alternative ways. So here comes us, the solution. Our system oversees the animals with any kind of standard security cameras. We analyze in the servers the data, and in the case of there is a sick animal, our artificial intelligence looking for behavioral patterns, and through our platform reminds the farmer or alert in case, and the farmer can go into the pen and intervene that specific one animal, so he has to not inject the full group. It's good for him because we can reduce his mortality rate based on the university studies with 50%, so half of it. This would mean him, after 1,000 pigs, 11,000 euro savings every year. Plus, we can only inject the sick animals, so we don't have to inject the whole group. Good for the farmer, but also good for us as consumers, because we don't consume the antibiotics. So farmers are already happy with us. And not just because of this. Speaking with the top insurance companies, Willis-Towers Watson, they can also give it a reduction or discount on the farmer insurance cost if they would use our system. We have a global market of 10 billion euro. We would like to start in Europe, where is a 2.2 billion euro market available. Our business model, basically subscription-based model for integrators and farmers, after every pick, so that they don't have to pay extra. And from the year two, we would like to sell the data for feed and genetic companies. We are unique. We are unique in a way that we are able to track animals inside in the pen. Cost-wise, we are equal with the antique mechanical methods. However, animal welfare, we are the highest because we are not using any kind of ear tags or hardwares on the animals, because we believe gathering data is possible without injuring the animals. So we focus on the software solution which can work the already installed cameras. Computer vision experts sucked by the automotive industry. It's hard to find them. We have them from Volvo and Tyson Group, and we have them with passion for agriculture. Myself, I worked at Nutreco, I worked at Philips, so I'm trying to combine my agriculture and technology knowledge to create change. We also backed up with the top, let's say, top agriculture universities, the Wageningen and Kaposvár universities, and professors from the beginning. And due to this, and due to our great team, we got the second place at the Nutreco AgriVision conference. We partnered up with StartLife. We got in the top AI accelerator, and we got in the top food tech accelerator here in Rome, where we are now. And that's not all. We also have pilots, and we also have partners. in different countries. In the Netherlands, we're working with Nutreco, biggest feed company, also with Topics. We're also working in Hungary with Cometa and Bonafarm. They are producing millions of pigs every year. And in Italy, we working together with Trau Nutrition Italia and also with the Young Farmers Association. And they introduced us to the farmers. So I spoke with the farmers, and I know from the farmers that changes are coming. Due to the regulation they are facing, they have to install cameras in their stables. So this is a huge opportunity for us. Due to the EU Action Plan 2017, it's going to be the same all around in Europe, and due to the UN agenda, it's going to be same worldwide. Probably you're asking about the technology. On selection day, we had 60% of our animal detection. We already reached last year 90%. This year, we are working on the analysis of the video streams, thanks to our great team. However, to finish our product, we are looking for €400,000, 60% for R&D, 11% for office and IP rights, because it's possible, and 29% for marketing and business development. I have an announcement today. We already gathered part of this amount from StartLife, from Seed Investor, and also from our piggy bank. So if you want to reduce the antibiotics usage and want to make agriculture safe, then come and join us today. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Christoph. So, questions for you. Well, the first one is your product, right? So you claim, what, 90% accuracy in animal detection. How do you put the gear up and go and detect group behavior or even individual behavior to track pathologies?
Basically, the technology is already available in other industries, like automotive, or Facebook announced it 2 days ago. They have already reaching over than the human eye, so they have over the 97.8%. However, to implement these technologies, you need a great team, and you need domain knowledge in the sector. We have them, and we also backed up with the professors and the universities. So we are trying to bring the already available technologies and put it into the agriculture to make it better for everybody and more sustainable.
Great. And you showed us a full list of partners and customers. Give me an example of a pilot, or more than one, that you really believe is significant to your development.
Yeah, I'm really proud of the farmers like Michele or Enrico, the guys who I met in Italy. However, I want to mention a big project which was in Hungary, the biggest Patener farm. They are struggling because they have 22,000 animals continuously, so they have to use a lot of human labor, and they have problems with the feeding system. So with our MVP, we can help them. Very simple solutions like counting and also to reduction of the human error. And this is already saving them €66,000 every year.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Thank you, Christoph.
Thank you very much.